But basically, just before we go on the drive, again, what we're going to be looking for is we're going to go on the highway, and once it's available, we're going to be looking at where it says radar ready, and the MID, it's going to say advanced drive ready. When that occurrence happens, just like our cruise control system, we're going to tap this button on the far right-hand corner of the steering wheel, and that will engage the system. If you want to increase or decrease the speed while we're on there, just like cruise control, you can hit the minus and the plus button. Okay. Any last question before we go?
Nope. And you will be directing me as to when to turn, right?
For sure.
Okay. Which way are we going out?
Left and back. And then being a drive. There we go.
Are we going this way?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Oh, I don't want to tap my... Ah, set the heads-up display. That there? Oh, that went off.
So you're looking to set the heads-up display. So we're looking to, we might be blocking these guys right here. But how we do that?
Let them out.
Sure.
Okay.
So how you do that is on the left-hand side of your steering wheel, sir, you're going to push over to the left.
Here?
Yes, sir. And keep doing that one, two, one more time. There we go. Press OK. And if you want to raise or lower it, now you can use that directional pad up and down to raise and lower.
Okay. Coming down. Okay. Oh, down too low. Now you can set how much information is in there. Because
yes, sir.
Right now all I see is a compass.
Yeah, there's not much right now.
Okay.
Once we're on the highway, it's going to change everything.
All right. Now that's all I have to do, right?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir. Right at the stop sign at the next, at the end of the road, we'll be taking a right as well. At the end of this road, we're going to take a right. And then we're going to try to merge over to the left lane as soon as we feel comfortable and safe to do so, because we'll be getting right onto the highway.
How much of a, oh, I could have gone. I didn't know how much of a merge lane we had here. Far left?
Yes, sir.
All the way over?
Yes, sir. One more. And now we're in the lane for going onto the highway here. Again, this is without having any destination in at all. So you're in full control here.
That's not good.
Oh, I've driven with you before. We're good. And then when you feel comfortable, just go into the next lane over to the left. Perfect. Stay right here. Now, in front of us, we have a two-lane exit going to the right. We're going to stay in this lane, but we're going to take the exit to Dallas North Tollway North. And advanced drive is already ready, so on the right-hand side of that steering wheel, go ahead and tap that button.
Advanced drive activated.
So it's currently in gray mode, which means hands-on. It's on hands-free mode, currently for now. So as we're going to continue on, this is where it's going to transition back to you in 0.5 of a mile. I can see that on the right-hand side of the screen. It's going to transition back to your hands in 3, 2, 1. It should come back up. There we go. Now that's going to transition back to you manually again. The reason for that is this junction that's coming up ahead of us for the highway is very, very short, so it wants you to be in control to do that.
If
part of that teammate aspect, working together with the vehicle. And as you can see, there's a lot of traffic coming up ahead. So when you feel comfortable at a point in time, we'll be taking control by hitting the accelerator. Now it's fully in your control.
Advanced drive ended.
Yeah, that seemed a little backwards to hit the accelerator versus the
brake. You can hit
the brake
too.
Oh, okay.
You could. But since we were going to continue on moving forward, I was suggesting the accelerator.
Oh, okay.
And then whenever you feel comfortable, we'll try to get into our middle lane there. Vehicle's checking everything over, its vehicle's initializing.
Now it seems like you would have the vehicle initializing, that information in the heads up would be easier to see rather than me trying to look down in the right corner.
And advanced drive is currently ready, which shows that in the heads up and also down below.
Okay, so now I can...
Yep, go ahead and press it.
Advanced drive activated.
It's currently hands-free. We're set at 66 miles an hour. So if you like, let's go ahead and raise the speed up to 70.
Yes.
Just because with a heavy traffic.
Yeah, they're going to run over me at 66.
So. You can see heavy traffic right now. You were kind of asking me before, will it ask for your hands to be on the wheel? No, it's got it.
So if somebody made a quick lane change in front of me, it would automatically hard brake?
Not hard brake, but it would do the necessary braking that it needs to give some distance, but it will not do a hard brake unless somebody stepped in front of you and slammed on their brakes. That's
right.
The only instance.
Would the system deactivate?
No, sir.
When that happens?
No, sir.
Oh, okay.
Not unless they came to you in a very abrupt stop in front of you and you needed to take manual control over in those adverse situations.
Right.
But it would still be operating, it would still brake for you.
Now, one of the things that I guess irks me about hands-free is you see people in the demos doing this. You can't, over time, this becomes very exhaustive.
Well, you saw me, Roosevelt. I had my hands in my lap.
Yeah, I know. But all the demos that you see of these systems, you have the person sitting in the car like this, ready to grip the steering wheel.
To me, that tells me they're not trusting the system.
Yeah.
I trust the system, you're trusting the system, and it works really, really well.
Okay.
It's earned my trust. I've spent a lot of time driving this vehicle, and it works really, really well.
So, resting my hands like this on my legs is no problem.
Absolutely. You can raise up your arm on the armrest if you feel
okay.
Like it, by all means.
So you don't have to be in a, okay, ready to grab the steering wheel position.
No, we have a built-in transition time, so when you do need to take control, it gives you some opportunity of time to raise your hands and grab the wheel.
And how many minutes did you say you could drive like this?
It was about 10 minutes, and then it asked for a reinitiation of just putting your hands on the wheel, verifying that you're paying attention, you're a part of the system working as a teammate, and then it'll transition back to blue to roll over your hands so you can enjoy the drive as well.
Right. At some point, will there be any voice activation integration where you can tell it to set itself or...
So when we look at route guidance, if you want to put a destination in, that we could do through voice. So then it would start understanding where we want to go on along the route. So that aspect, yes. However, if you say, I want to turn into the next lane, no, we don't have that. Or raise the speed, we don't have that in the system.
But is it in the system to say, okay, activate?
No. Only thing we have voice is to be able to put the destination in.
Okay.
Great question. So the next thing I'm going to have you do, Roosevelt, is after you can see that toll booth that's coming across here, now we've driven in this mode for a little while in this lane, we're actually going to initiate a manual lane change to where you're asking the car to do a changing of the lane. Does that sound fair enough?
Okay.
So how we're going to do that is the turn signal stock on the left-hand side of the steering wheel, when I tell you to do so, you're going to raise that up to the first detent. So there's two notches in it. So we're going to raise it to the first one. We're going to hold it there. Oh, not yet.
Okay.
just I want to make sure you understand what we're going to do. You're going to raise that up and hold it there until you hear a beep in the car. Then it's going to ask for your hands to go on the wheel. Check your blind spot to the right. And then it's going to initiate over. Fair enough?
Okay.
All right. So go ahead and raise that up. First detent. Put the hands on the wheel.
Right.
Okay, your blind spot monitor
starting
to the right. And now it's initiating that over. Hands on the wheel still.
Oh,
so
I have
transition
to do it.
Off.
It's
yep.
Manual.
Hands in all
okay.
the way. Any lane change that we're doing, it wants you to be in manual control. To have hands on the wheel just in case something happens. So why it did that meandering is when you let go, it wanted to go back in the lane to keep you safe.
So lane changing is always manual.
Not always. I just showed you a manual request because we don't have any destination put in.
Okay.
On the way back, we'll have a destination in. It's going to suggest when to do the lane change for you. I'm trying to show you the whole package.
Right. And when it suggests that I do a lane change, I have to go through what you just had me to do?
No, it'll actually be hands on the steering wheel, and then you'll look at your blind spot, and you just look at the mirror, and then it will initiate the blinker, and it'll merge over for you when necessary.
Okay.
So here it's already paying attention to the cars around us. It's paying attention that it's looking to identify where it needs to brake or accelerate for this vehicle. Go ahead and brake.
Yeah.
Because that car was going up and back yep. and forth, changing their speed. Part of teammate working together. We'll go ahead and we're going to take this exit here. Coming up.
Now it's going to brake, right?
You're braking now. You're
I'm
in full control because you hit the brake earlier, so you took back over full control. So you have the gap that we have directly in front of us off to the left. We're actually going to be taking a left-hand turn there. There is opposing traffic, so just know we're
right
going to take
here.
A left turn. Correct. Yeah, we can kind of see. We'll be taking a left there. And once we go right up to the stop sign, I'll have you come to complete stop, and then I'll put in our route guidance going back so you can kind of see how it operates with route guidance. Destination in. And last button, I'm going to hit OK. Downloading everything from the cloud, so we have the recent maps and data. And we're ready to go, sir. Whenever you feel comfortable.
Nice little blind spot there.
And then very shortly, you're going to start seeing an on-ramp to take back onto the highway that we'll take. Right here.
Whoa, look at that cloud.
That's a lot of rain in front of us.
It looks like a funnel.
It almost does.
Ooh.
Yeah, whenever you feel comfortable, Roosevelt, we're going towards that cloud coming in.
Unfortunately, gee.
It's not quite linked up to the weather stations yet.
No.
But when you feel comfortable, we'll go into the next lane over. We have some traffic coming.
Right. That is a serious funnel. Come on, car.
Advanced drive's already ready. You can go ahead and tap the button on the steering
wheel. Advanced drive activated.
So far,
like I said, once you learn a little bit more about the system, it's great.
now that we have a destination put in Roosevelt, you can, the car will start telling you what the next actions are. Right hand side of your multi-information display, you can see there, showing the next action. So you can see in 0.8 miles, it's going to ask to do a automated assist lane change. So we're going to guide with the car, and we're going to actually suggest to go into the next lane in 0.7 miles. And then from there, you can see the next action is 4.5 miles, which will be the exit that we'll be taking.
So you read this from bottom up?
Correct, sir.
Now, situation like this, we're coming up on the merge to the right, and there's a car on the right. Let's say if that car hangs real close to you, what do you do? Speed up or brake or?
That is completely up to you based on, you wouldn't brake necessarily. The car will, you'll see right here, hold on the steering wheel. It's going to ask for you to do it. You're going to look at your blind spot to your right.
Right lane change started.
And it's starting to do the steering already for you. You can look ahead forward. You're still hands on the wheel. Again, every time we're doing any lane change,
hands on the wheel. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, the reason I have to look at the mirror is because of the eye. The system is reading my eyes.
Yep. I just wanted to make sure you're checking the blind spot just
right.
to make sure.
Now, if I didn't check the blind spot, what would it do?
It would not do a lane change at all. It would stay in that lane, sir.
Okay.
Currently hands-free. So we're in blue mode.
Okay. Blue is hands-free.
Yes, sir.
All right. Gray is
hands-on.
Hands-on.
But a light touch.
Now, are those colors set, or is that something that the driver can change?
That is set. So it's asking about the hands on the wheel because the lane markings there deviated. There's no lane marking for more than 2 seconds, so it wants to make sure that your hands are on the wheel. That's tracking right.
So, is there any facial recognition in that system?
As far as who you are, no. What it's doing is it maps out your eyes to see for eyelids opening close.
Okay.
It creates a horizontal line directly across your eyes, and then creates a vertical line from your nose to your chin, just so that way you can see if you're nodding off or falling asleep.
And whether or not, if you're wearing shades, it still can do
it
that.
Can still operate, however, there are some shades that it cannot see if it's infrared blocking because it is an infrared camera.
Okay.
That's where it would not be able to work on hands-free mode. Hands-on mode, like you currently have right now, this mode, it would be able to handle that.
And would it give you some kind of any warning or indication that it can't read it, or it wouldn't?
It just would not engage you.
Okay.
Ready to do a transition into another highway? From one highway to another?
Yeah.
All right, so that's coming up next. 0.7 miles, Roosevelt. Basically what's gonna happen, we're gonna do our junction from this highway onto Sam Rayburn Tollway southbound. For this, what's gonna happen is it's first gonna ask for your hands to go on the wheel when we get to it. Then it's gonna ask for you to check your blind spot just to make sure there's no one in the breakdown lane. It'll turn the blinker on for us, and then it's gonna steer into the lane for us, and slow down and steer all the way through. So it's asking for hands on.
Advanced drive will keep right ahead.
Telling you it's going to take the exit ahead, not the first one. We are going to the second one. Again, it's doing all the steering necessary, very light touch. Now it's going to ask for you to look at your blind spot monitor. So go ahead and take a look at the right. It's your mirror. We're looking good. Straight ahead. Very light touch. It's doing all the steering in. Hands on. There you go. You're good. It's doing all decelerating for you. It's running an exit ramp. And in front of us, we have a junction, northbound and southbound. It's going to take the southbound for you, so it will steer all the way in. Very light touch again. It's doing all the acceleration, braking, and steering necessary. Just very light touch. Light touch. Yep. Got blue mode for a little bit. Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, blue for a little bit.
It was happy for you. Then here in this situation here, in the junction where it's going to be merging both lanes, again, it's going to stay in this lane all the way to the end of the dotted line and then continue the merger. Just paying attention to the traffic around us to find the spot.
And in a merge, it didn't ask me to check the blind spot.
It did not, and it was not necessary.
Okay.
The car was handling all that for you. In this situation here, we're going to take this exit that's directly in front of us. Very shortly, it's going to go back to blue mode. It's going to take this exit all the way hands-free. So we're back to hands-free. Transition back to manual. So it goes to the hands because we're getting off the highway. Ask for you to take control, hit the brake, or the accelerator, take control.
Advanced drive ended.